Yo, this is Jay Stu, repping ACK, the one and only All City Kicks, and right now you're tuned in to All for the Love. Entrepreneur since I was a small kid, so it started a long time ago with the mentality, with the work ethic, but with All City Kicks, the business that I currently own, me and my partner developed that idea roughly 2003. Business is it's so many things. It's time, it's energy, it's patience, it's struggle. It's achievements, it's ups and downs, but ACK is here, and we going strong. Since I was a kid, EP, I've been, you know, this is what I've been doing, man. You know, one way, shape, form, or another, you know, I've been out here grinding, doing all types of different ventures to be my own boss. You know, so working for someone else, that's really not an option for me. But that's me. Not for everybody ain't cut out for this. ACK, we carry exclusive sneakers made by a number of manufacturers. You got big names, Nike, Adidas, Reebok, Puma. You got smaller brands that's on the rise, Creative Recreation, A-Life, Clay, to name a few. And we carry streetwear apparel. Streetwear apparel is something that's kind of coming to the light, coming to the fold over the past 5 or 6 years. It's been around for over 10 years. A lot of brands that created it, you know, originate from New York and California, but we currently carry brands like Crooks and Castles, that's out of LA. Big shout out to my man Rich, 10D, what I'm rocking right now. Big shout out to E, Josh, that's out of NY. We got A-Life Apparel, as well as shoes, that's out of NY. A couple other brands, Rocksmith, Tokyo. Big shout out to Ralph over there at Rocksmith. My favorite brand right now, as far as apparel goes, I'm a big fan of the Crooks and Castles. That's out to LA. Big ups to Dennis and all the Crooks out there that's doing it big right now. I like it. They brands for a couple different reasons. One, I love the name Crooks and Castles. The theory behind that name is behind every castle lies a crook, and every crook is chasing a castle. Man, you know me all my life, bro. You know what I'm saying? You know how I get down. I've been a fashion connoisseur. Because I'm not a collector, you know what I'm saying? I rock mine. So I've been like that since I was a kid. Always loving fashion, always loving sneakers, wanting the newest, you know, the flashiest stuff out there. So that's been in me since I was a kid. And, you know, I'm still living that way. I'm still a big kid, living a dream.
So Vic is your partner. And you guys started a clothing brand called Cooley Brand, right?
Yep.
And how long did you guys run that?
Cooley Brand, we developed that in 1999 when we first met. And we did that for about 4 years. For roughly 5 years, you know, it was a concept that we both came up with together once we met and got to know each other. Fashion was something that we shared in common, so we knew we wanted to be, you know, in the industry, in the game, in some way, shape, or form, and that was the way that we, you know, we attacked it. Unfortunately, you know, it didn't pan out like, you know what I'm saying, like we probably would have wanted it to, but we learned a lot, you know, got to see a lot, and we accomplished some things, so it's no regrets. I mean, it's always, you know what I'm saying, it's always going to be Cooley, baby, constantly overcoming all obstacles life exposes you. Wow. One thing about our situation is, you're right, I do have a partner. I break bread on that first and say that if you're looking to go into business with a partner, you know, make sure you handle the legalities of it properly. That is different, a lot different than going business for yourself. Obviously, with yourself, you're solo. You don't take on another person's responsibilities or issues. Just know that if you're going into it with a partner, it's just like anything else. You got partners with marriage, teammates, whatever. You need to be aware of their situation as well. But we first met, you know, obviously we had a lot of things in common. And just starting out, you know, it was just both of us getting out there, learning, researching, talking to different people, you know. Do your research. That's, research is everything. And anything that you want to do or get into, man, real talk, we was doing Cooley, and we was out at these trade shows, you know, trying to find different things for our clothing line. We was looking for zippers and buttons and stuff like that. And, you know, we'd look over and it'd be a shoe company over there. And, you know, us being big in the sneakers, you know, instead of spending time on our, you know what I'm saying, our specific stuff that we needed for our fashion line, we'd creep off over into, you know what I'm saying, a booth with a company like Puma or Pony. You know, at them times they were, you know, they had a lot of movement going on, and, you know, Nike and Adidas, and we wasn't getting our stuff done for the fashion line. We was too busy looking at sneakers. So one time we was out at one of the shows out in Vegas, at the Magic Show. We came up with the idea, like, man, you know, why don't we do something with these shoes? Physically in this, but how could we tell if we was meant to be in bliss if you're not mentally as well? This energy you're sending me is tricky as hell. Usually it's like a 50-50, we could take a L before we start things at this point. And, you know, G-Rap, Grand Rapids, Michigan, you know, where we located, we ain't have a spot that was, you know what I'm saying, catering to, you know, exclusive different type of sneakers. You know, you had the mall, Foot Action, Foot Locker, you know, all that, but come on, I seen a movement coming with this whole industry, you know what I'm saying? I lived in different parts of the country, you know, I visited a lot of parts of the country, big city, you know, and that, you know, you go to the big cities and you see the different ideas that they put in their stores, the different vibes, the different feels, and it gives you a feeling that I want to shop here, that I, you know, this is where I want to pick up, you know what I'm saying, my gear from, you know what I'm saying? It's something about when you walk into a store, you know what I'm saying, and they got, you know, some banging beats bumping, you know, you got a, you know what I'm saying, some fly looking people, some good looking people, females for sure, up in there, you know, you might have some screens going, you know, with the games or, you know, anything, it's a lot of different things, elements that you add to it. You know, down at ACK, you know, we got all that for you, along with the literature, you know what I'm saying? You get to see a lot of artwork, by a lot of local artists. You know, and it was just to create an experience, man, to give people an attitude, a good feeling about themselves when they come in and shop with us. Kick open the door to ACK, what do you see? Man, color, energy, texture, attitude. You see life, man. You know, you walk in there, we got, I'm not gonna give off physical details because, you know, that's just not how we get down. You know, it's all about the feeling you get when you come in there. It's one of being welcomed. We definitely like to communicate with everybody that comes in, put them up to different brands, put them up to different materials that they may not be familiar with. So it's one of comfort, excitement, sexiness. Over the next 3 years, we plan a lot of different things, man. One of the biggest areas that we want to focus on is our website. As everybody knows out there, the web is huge. And it's open 24/7. Something that, you know, there's no way getting around that. To have a better presence, to have a better presentation, a better functional website, we're definitely looking for the growth of that. As far as right here in the store, you know, we got a few changes. We got a whole art display program that we're going to institute this next year, where it's going to involve a lot of local artists and some that aren't from the area, where we're going to have like a rotating art display in the store, which we're excited about. We love art down at the store. I used to get down a little bit back in the day, you know, Pete, you know what I'm saying, myself, so I don't know if I'm going to quite put one of my masterpieces up, but it's a chance. But we got a lot of things popping off, man. We're getting big in the community out here. We got a thing with my alma mater, GR Central, Grand Rapids Central, where we're going to be sponsoring. It's going to be the ACK Halftime Shootout, where different students from Central High School are going to get selected by the faculty, by the staff, to participate at halftime of the boys' basketball games, and we'll get opportunity to win prizes directly from All City Kick. So we're excited about that. It's something for the kids to give back to the community. We also do a lot of volunteer work with two other schools here, Ottawa Hills High School, which I definitely got love for because I did a little bid up there too. That's where me and my man P used to roam the halls. But up at the O, you know, we was Indians, now y'all Bengals, but I don't know how I feel about that. But yeah, we up there, and we up at Creston. Love for them too. My sister is a polar bear, so both of them schools got schools of small business within their curriculum, so we do some volunteer work, try to get up there and talk to the kids, try to put them on to some game about being entrepreneur, being in business, you know, just real life knowledge, man, that maybe them books can't put you on. So you know, the community, the store, the web. I mean, we got a lot of stuff planned, man. We all over the place out here. You know, we're going to continue our movement with the branding. You're going to see a lot more items with the ACK logo and the insignias and all of that, you know, coming at you. So, you know, man, over the next 3 years, it's going to be crazy. But I think, you know, what we're doing here is definitely groundbreaking for our area. For the time that we, you know, that we did, you know, break through the door. First off, like I said earlier, I'm a connoisseur. I'm not a collector. I don't put my shoes up and save them for 20 years and all of that type of stuff. You know what I'm saying? I rock my joints because I like to look fresh. I like to look fly. But my man EP got me out here with just a couple selections of mine. How I get down. Another thing, you know, I'm 78, you know what I'm saying? I'm 1978. That was the year I touched down, you know what I'm saying? So I'm 3-0, so I go all over the place, you know what I mean? I go back, you know what I'm saying, way back, like, you know, Puma, Sky 2, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of love for this shoe. This is a basketball shoe, you know what I'm saying? I did a little time out on the court, a lot more time when I was a little younger, not so much time these days, but you know, this was an old retro basketball shoe that Puma put out. I believe this shoe came out in like 82, but the Sky 2 Puma. Ponies, get your game up if you don't know the heritage. City Wings, for some of y'all, you may remember Lil Man Spud Webb rocked City Wings when he shocked the world, baby. Shocked the world. City Wings, though, ponies. Colorway, sick. He had flyers, baby. This is the Glide. This is Bob Cousy. And like I said, I'm a connoisseur. I rock them. So, yeah, it's a little dirt on there. You know, it's all good, though. Right here, we got the Blue Suede. Come on, man. What you know about those? All y'all cats that, you know what I'm saying? That, you know, keep y'all stuff in the box. Don't ever rock them. Rock your joints, man. My man that I grew up admiring, MJ. I was a big MJ fan. I know a lot of y'all run around try to collect these, but like I said, I rock mine. But right there, it's the Jordan 9. It's one of the dopest ones to me. Used to call these the Moon Mans. These came out when I was a freshman. P, you remember these?
I remember those.
Freshman year, baby. Yeah. One more for you. I ain't bring too many of them out there. I mean, everybody know what Jordans look like. You know what I'm saying? I mean, hey. It's too many of them out there now, but I still got love for him, so I had to break out a couple. And these right here, these is one of some of my favorites. The sixes, I used to like the, you know what I'm saying, the two hoes and the tongue. You know. I still remember when Jay was rocking these, boy. Woo. Sick right there. On to some different type of stuff. Like I said, I'm well-rounded, baby. I got flavors, you know, more than Baskin Robbins too. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I ain't gonna break it out like that, but New Balance. New Balance was a company that I really liked. New Balance comes from a running heritage. You could look at that shoe and tell it's running. It's an old retro running shoe. This one right here is actually called the 320. And that's you know what I'm saying? I mean, that's something crazy. That's something different. You ain't gonna see too many of these. Big ups to NY. I got these in NY like 97. You know. See, I just ain't start doing this, man. Like so many of y'all cats. If we had more time, I bring y'all some joints from like 93. May try to front on the Felis, you know what I'm saying? But back in the day, when I was a shorty, if you had these on, you had some clout around here. You know what I mean? So, don't, man, get your game up, man. Cause we from the glove, baby. Come on, man. P.
I remember.
Come on, man. This is championship year. This is 85. Glenn Rice was who? Glenn, hey, for any, man, y'all out there, go get some old footage of Michigan basketball with Glenn Rice, Ramil Robinson, Lloyd Vaught, big ups, East Kentwood, that's a Grand Rapids boy. Big up Lloyd Vaught. They was hooping in these. The dunk, Nike dunks, though. That's what this is. I love the Wolverines, but I was a big Syracuse fan. P, you know that. You know what I'm saying? Them right there, them Sherm Douglas, DC, Derek Coleman, Ronnie Cycli days. You know?
Derek Coleman was rookie of the year, and a lot of people don't even remember that.
Though. Oh, yeah. Oh, and my boy, from Syracuse, Billy Owens. Billy didn't play in these. He was a little after this. He wasn't that quite old, but Billy O. What's up, baby? Where you at out here? First, Bo Jack. Some people get them confused, man. This was the first Bo Jackson. And for all y'all that don't even know who Bo Jackson was, this is a company that came on the scene 2002. We opened up with this company. Right here, it's called Creative Recreation, and you know, their whole spin on the sneaker game is kind of to make a more casual sneaker, you know, a more high-end, more a sneaker that wouldn't be so athletic looking. This is one of their models, the Coco High, and I like them because of the materials they use, the different colors they use. I mean, come on, man, where you seeing a shoe like that? The gold shoe. Remember Michael Johnson wore the gold shoes? Mm-hmm. These like my Michael Johnsons. You know, I pull these out when I wanna be a little flashy or something. EP, I wanna say a big thanks, man. Give you a big shout out for coming through. Giving me the chance to be on All for the Love and getting down and letting people hear my story, hear the story of ACK. You know, we go way back. You like a brother, man, and to see us sitting here as grown men today, it definitely touches me, something that I'm proud of. You know, us coming up as businessmen, and everything that you've done for me and for us, I just want to say thank you and give a big shout out to Two Youth and an Elder Productions. Thank you for everything, man. And to the masses, I wanna thank y'all for listening, taking time out. I know time is money, so I wanna thank y'all for listening, for checking us out, coming to the store, copping, or any type of support. So thank you to the masses, to the public out there. Hey, it ain't much more. Act like you know. All for the love, baby.